different, or what do you think the difference was?
Their personnel is a little different. I think that, you know, we've always said if we don't score in transition, we struggle at times. And we played right into Mercer's hands the first and second quarter. Their zone, we got stagnant, pass and stand and pass and stand and pass and stand some more, you know. And for us to have the size advantage we did, we weren't getting the ball inside. I think our first five or six shots were all threes. And so, you know, the message at halftime was you've got to set pace. You've got to control tempo. And I think in the third quarter, we were able to get out, run, get some easy buckets in transition, and then set our defense a little bit better.
I know Shakovia didn't score a lot of points, and she didn't have any, you know, until late, but she certainly contributed in other ways. Can you talk a little bit about, you know, what she does when she's not scoring?
Well, that's the thing. You know, she does so many things for our team. She rebounds basketball. She pushes in transition. She gets steals. She's guarding the best player. You know, she's truly an all-around player. And I think sometimes because she scores so well, the other things that she does go unnoticed until a night like tonight. You know, when teams are playing us a zone, she's going to have not as many opportunities as she has when she can take her man one-on-one. And that's where she has matured and understands that if I'm not scoring, then I've got to go and do other things for the team. But if, you know, if she doesn't play tonight, I don't know if we win because of everything else that she just does for our team.
And Tiara, another, you know, lights out night. You know, how do you explain that? She's really on fire now.
You know, she's playing really well. I'm extremely proud for her. We've asked her to do a lot. We're asking her to guard the best player or the second best player, you know, her and Kobe. And then, you know, to go rebound the basketball and to push in transition and to also penetrate. You can't just be a spot-up shooter, but when they leave you open, knock it down. So I think she's just really worked hard this summer on elevating her game, and I think that's what you see on the floor. And she's got more in the tank than that. You know, she's been very, I call it Mississippi laid back. You know, she's got this Mississippi laid back little swagger to her, but she can't be that way on the floor. And so she's slowly kind of emerging out of that.
Merritt Hempe also had a great night, double-double for her. She's been performing well the past few games as well. What has kind of been the contribution to that?
You know, I think for her, we challenged her from rebounding the basketball. We lost Chris O'Donnell, who was a really good rebounder for her last year and just really aggressive inside. And so she's really made a concentrated effort to go to the boards, whether it's defensively or offensively. And that does two things for her. It gives her confidence, but it also gives her putbacks or gets her fouled and gets, you know, points at the free throw line. So, you know, our message to Merritt this summer was you've got to get to the free throw line more. You've got to be more active and you've got to rebound the basketball. And I think, again, you know, she has taken that and put it into action.
This is backtracking maybe a little bit, but in light of recent events, how did you handle taking over for such a beloved coach, such a legendary coach? How did you kind of handle that transition?
Well, I think it's, you know, number one, understanding what you're stepping into and just, you know, for me, being able to work with Coach Landers for the last 4 years, I had a really good understanding of the program that he built, the legacy that he created, that is Georgia basketball. And so, you know, for me, it was about respecting him and the tradition and trying to uphold the legacy that he created.
Yeah. Did you ever feel like you had to walk a balance, I guess, between revamping versus holding that tradition? We talked about that some, but
no, not really. You know, I feel like a lot of the things that you see now are things that, you know, even Coach Landers wanted to do, but roster and injuries and other things dictated, you know, his ability to push the basketball and some other things that maybe we're doing a better job of now. The other thing is that we have four seniors on the floor, and that makes a big difference, you know. But the biggest thing is just really being yourself. You know, there's a lot of things that we do that are Georgia basketball that is Andy Landers. Why would I go away from what he did for 36 years that got him 5 Final Fours, 2 national championship games? And then there's some things that I've taken from my years as an assistant. So you kind of blend that together and just kind of use what works.
How tight were you and Coach Richt?
You know, this past year when I became head coach, I had an opportunity to be with him at some events and some GDA activities. And so I can't say that we were extremely close, but as an assistant, to be able to observe him and watch how he handles, you know, his team and his players and the young men that he coaches is something that, you know, I aspire to do as a head coach. I don't know what better role model you can have, you know, when you talk about a coach. Mm-hmm.
And, can you kind of, expand the reversal of roles for Mercer, you know, in the first half, knocking down a lot of threes to the second half of Griffin, be able to, you know, to create space of her own, be able to knock down threes of her own?
Well, we knew they were going to play us a zone for 40 minutes. So it was just about not being tight, shooting shots in rhythm for us, and working the ball inside out. And I think in the first, you know, two quarters, what you saw was pass and pass and pass and then shoot. the third and fourth quarter, the ball went inside out a little bit more. So the ball goes inside, it collapses the defense, then you can kick it out and you have more open shots. And for us, you know, I think they got threes in the second quarter. We went a little bit of zone, and just not knowing where shooters are, being slow to get there, and that's something that we improved on in the third and fourth quarter as well.
Is that it?